we're paying our respects right now.
To,
I'm kneeled at where Henri... Okay, so here's what I think happened, okay? Because I didn't really understand completely what was going on when the dude gave me Henri's sword. So, he said, like, that she had gone off somewhere. Here's her sword. She doesn't want me to follow. So I'm guessing that once she completed her mission, which was to make it to Aldrich, then she was like, all right, I'm done. And then she just kind of, like, gave up, you know, and she, like, opted out. Is that what happened?
Yeah, that's pretty fair assessment. That's what I got out from it, right? Is that, you know, she's kind of lost everything in the world. If you think about it, her best friend was Horus. That's no long. He's not there anymore.
Yeah.
And she's completed her mission, which was to.
Was I not her friend?
Slay Aldrich.
Continue. Yes. Yes. Yes.
Just. I mean, you were, but like you were her last friend, and like you were all she had left. That's why she gave you her sword, and was like, okay, don't follow me.
That was her mission. Her mission was to slay Aldrich, right? I forget like what her quest was.
Slay Aldrich.
And then that's it?
Yeah. I think if you read into the lore, Aldrich is, you know, devourer of gods, and basically devoured Astora as well.
Oh.
So like.
Oh, jeez.
So okay. There's a lot of lore behind it. And so she's like, that's why she's on her quest, is to slay Aldrich, to, basically get vengeance for herself.
So like I noticed like Oscar of Astora, and then she's Henri of Astora. So Astora is a place, or is it a person?
It's a kingdom.
It's a kingdom. So Aldrich destroyed Astora.
Yeah.
The kingdom of Astora, I guess.
I'm assuming, yes.
So she wanted to get vengeance.
Yes.
I'm gonna homeward bone. But now that she completed her quest, she was like, all right, I got nothing left. And then she just, like, opted out of life.
Pretty much. Yeah.
Girl, you know, you could have helped me on my quest now. I mean, I helped you on your quest. Why don't you help me on my quest? What did you leave your pre-made? And then I'll bring my pre-made.
I'll bring you into my pre-made.
I'll bring you into my pre-made. Did you ever read the description of this thing?
What?
The dullest type of blade found in the ruined land of Astora. Oh, it is the land of Astora.
The ruined land of Astora.
Land of Astora, yes. The dullest type of blade, though. Only it was once the blade of an earnestly noble figure, and its attacks. Oh yeah, oh it's a lucky sword. That was the thing about it.
Yes, it's boosted by the luck stat.
Damn it, Henri.
I know, right? Like
after all we've been through.
Yeah, but it's like the nature of Dark Souls. Like all like hope in the world just kind of drains. As the fire fades.
Yeah. Yes.
So anyway, I'm at the Dragonbearer, so.
Okay. Let's continue with our quest, because we are not giving up hope right now.
Although it's interesting that you talk about, like, how you mentioned that she was hollowing.
Yeah.
But it's also interesting that we, as we're not hollowing, we're unkindled.
My interpretation of that was that We never really hollow unless we, like, rage quit from the game and never play it anymore. Then, like, our guy is essentially hollow. We are not hollow because the player themselves are still inhabiting the avatar.
I mean, there's hollow, and then there's hollow, and then there's hollow, right?
Wait, there's hollow, and then there's hollow, and then there's hollow?
So, I mean, hollowing is the effect of when you know, your character basically turns into a zombie. Like,
yes.
Dark Souls 1 and 2. In Dark Souls 3, when you die, you don't turn into a raisin.
That's
you
right.
Stay
we,
human.
We don't have a dead face.
And so it's interesting that the curse affects us differently.
In this game.
Yes.
Yeah, I don't know why that is.
And it's not sure. I'm not sure if Henri is supposed to be unkindled, or I think she's supposed to be hollow, right? Because she and Horus are hollowing. I put that in quotes. Or they hollow. But I mean, like, Sigward mentions that he's unkindled.
You're making me want to look up. I need to take another look at the sword. Yeah, Henri, it says another unkindled. It belonged to Henri, whom is another unkindled. So she was unkindled as well.
Right.
But she hollowed. I mean, that's hollowing, right? Her and Horus, they attacked hollowed. Me.
Yeah.
So they hollowed.
But since we're not hollowing in the traditional sense of turning into a zombie, it's interesting to think about what it means in this world to be what is hollowing. What does it mean to hollow, and what is the context in which it is? And I'm saying this because there is some lore behind it.
There is, okay. Again, to anybody not familiar with the lore, like, hollowing is when you become a zombie.
Yeah, it's...
In the other games, when you die and you revive at the bonfire, you come back as a zombie face.
Yeah.
And then you can, like, pop an item to...
You pop, like, a humanity or an effigy to reverse your hollowing.
Yeah, in this game, it's you pop an ember.
And you,
but
so
in this game, you
like,
don't... Yeah, in this game, you don't become a zombie face when you die.
Yes.
So, yeah. The other thing, too, is that we don't ever see Horus or Henri's faces, so we don't even know if they have zombie faces underneath when they hollow.
Yes. I mean, I think for Henri, it's done for reasons to be like, you know, you don't see her face so she can be gender neutral.
What's a girl for?
If you play as a girl, Henri is a guy.
Oh, I forgot you mentioned that, right?
Yes, and if you play as a guy, Henri is a girl.
Is the name always Henri?
Yes, because Henri, I believe in the Japanese translation of Henri, is a gender neutral name. Or something like that. I think up here we can actually get a little something else.
Dude, that melts my brain.
Why?
I forgot that Henri is the opposite gender of whatever your character is.
Yes, and there's a reason for that. I am saying this because this game merits a second and a third playthrough.
Okay.
This chest is safe.
You hear that, guys? Just because you watch this playthrough doesn't mean you can't still enjoy Dark Souls 3.
Yes. Wow. I actually was wondering if you wanted to at one point have kind of a pseudo podcast to discuss like the lore of Dark Souls.
Maybe one day. We'll see. Whoa. Where are we going?
Oh, I'm just like walking around. There's some stuff down there, but we can always get it later. Or you can
stuff.
Always get it later.
Stuff.
Okay.
Shiny. Red Tearstone Ring. Sounds like a magic using thing. Could this be an illusory wall? Impossible. It looks like it is one.
Right. What? No, so we can actually drop down right here.
Huh? Oh. Does not look safe. What the?
Oh, nope, don't do it that way.
Okay.
I was trying to be slick about it. Trying to do a whole dramatic
slip. That was the opposite of slick. Okay,
I think I can get back there so I can join you.
Let me just see if I just inch my way down. Okay, that was close.
Okay, I'll meet you on that ledge.
Okay. Let me just make sure there's not anything that I'm missing over here.
Just hit the bonfire and we can go fight it. That is now my go-to sentence now for this game.
Oh, there's Kythus chime. Kephis's chime.
Oh no.
Oh
no, you just reminded me of you remember when we, what was it? When Revan and Swarter showed up, spoilers. You were like, when he took off his mask, and you were like, oh no, don't let it be Kephas.
God, everybody's afraid that it's Kephas. Pilgrim ahead, what the hell is this?
Okay, my sign is down on that ledge that you dropped down.
Oh, I'm standing in front of knights right now.
Oh no, where did you go?
Can you put your sign down a few more drops?
A few more. Okay. So I dropped down another time. Okay, and then you dropped down. Okay, I dropped my sign down at the lowest point that I can be at before I drop down and fight the knights. I'm assuming that's where you are, right? Right?
Yes. Yes. I hope that you put the sign on the right spot. Because it might not be what you're thinking.
I don't know where you are then.
I'm waiting for your sign to show up.
Like, are you on the little, like, rook-looking ledge?
No, I'm not on the rook. I'm below the rook. Oh, I see where you placed your sign. I'm lower than that.
You're, like, literally in front of the knights by the suit of armor.
Yeah. I'm not in front of the knights. So there's the rook, right? If you drop down from the rook, like, there's the dead armor. There's a dead dude, like...
Yes.
I'm standing, like, right behind the dead dude up on that little...
Oh, okay, then.
On that little ledge or whatever.
That's easy.
Okay.
Why did you drop down this far?
I don't know.
Do you...
Sometimes when I'm talking, I'm not conscious of where I'm actually moving. And then when I stop talking and I look at what just happened, I'm like, oh, I'm here.
I hope you can see my sign.
I hope I can see your sign as well.
I've already dropped it.
Okay. All right, yes, perfect, perfect. Okay. Unable to summon Phantom!
Really?
No.
Really?
No, do it again.
Oh, no, I failed to create my summon sign. Oh, no, it's doing this bullshit again.
Oh, no.
Let me log out. Can we cut so I can fix this?
Yeah. All right, so we just went back because, like, we had so much trouble with, like, summoning and crap. So I just homeward boned back to the bonfire, and we're starting from here now.
Yes.
So let's go fight the boss, right? We're going to go fight the boss now.
Let's fight the boss.
Oh god, the dragon. Okay, never mind.
Dragon's dead. Oh, that's right. We need to vanquish this fucking butt face.
Is it... We can do it. We don't have to go fight the boss. We can do this first.
Yeah, we can go fight it, but it's on the way to the boss.
Okay, yeah.
Very easy.
Kill the priest.
Kill the priest!
Kill the beast!
Good shot.
Nice. Bitch.
Yeah.
Was that, did you stagger him?
Yeah.
That was awesome. Was that a parry?
No, that was a guard block.
Oh.
Or a guard break.
Oh.
Come on, I want the parry off this guy.
Oh, okay.
Well, I'm not gonna get it right now.
Oh, God. Oh, yeah, I didn't...
Oh, I got it!
Nice! The priest is like, oh, no! Oh, he... Yeah. Oh, God, that was awesome.
Well, you gotta get yourself paramittens.
Paramittens?
See, whenever I say paramittens, I'm just imagining that my character has this giant sword, and he's got, like, mittens on, like, cooking mittens.
Cooking mittens. Or big cat paw mittens.
Oh, hey, look, the store's open.
Yeah, I opened it.
Oh, that's right, because this is where this goes. Oh, okay.
Oh!
Ah.
Oh, jeez. Whoa. Nice.
Let's see. Can I get the victory parry? Oh, I got it.
My bloodthirst was too much. Okay, so.
So I think, yeah. So if we come right here, we can drop down and we can fight the thing.
Okay.
Here, let me heal you first.
I accept your healing. Okay.
Shit. It curses. Are you down?
No.
Okay.
Well, that works.
What'd you do?
Throwing firebombs from up above.
No, don't kill me! Don't let him kill me!
Don't let him kill me! I'm gonna drop down.
Okay. Woo.
Is it gonna fade away? Yeah. Titanite chunk. Large titanite shard.
Yes.
Soul of a crestfallen knight. Well, that felt good.
Yes. And then look. Open up the door.
Okay. Ah!
You done good.
No.
Dark Souls lesson for today is never trust chests.
There was, I was like, oh, well, there's nobody wrote anything. Nobody wrote anything, so I guess it's fine. don't they? If I like, oh god, never mind. I was gonna say
you can check. Look at the chain.
The chain?
Yes.
If there is or is not a chain,
you have to look it up. But the chains are a different pattern for mimics. A regular chest has it looping around in a circle,
uh-huh.
Where a mimic just has it trailing off in a line.
Okay.
Also, if you look really carefully. You can see mimic chests moving, like breathing. Alright, so hit the bonfire and then we're gonna go fight the mimic. Wait, where'd you go anyway? Oh, there you are. Oh yeah, we actually now can access that room really quickly.
Oh.
Yeah, up there.
I'm crestfallen.
It'll be easy. Actually, shit. No! No! Oh, I just thought it would be easier to get to that room than it was. Alright, well, let's go through the main room. Beat the shit out of these guys again. This guy can die.
This guy can die.
This guy can get owned in the face. Oh,
no.
Okay, I'm coming. Oh, rip soul. You have truly become crestfallen.
My souls!
How many souls was it?
I don't even know.
Okay, next time we have to attack everything as a unit.
I'm so bad at this game.
You just need to beat it once and then...
There you are.
Should I hold your hand?
No, I'm rushing forward. I'm rushing forward. That's the winning strategy.
Don't go hollow.
No. I'll be seeing you, Henri.
Henri of Astora.
Oh, God. He found me. I don't know how, but he found me.
Oh, is Shitty...
No.
What's that guy's name? Shitty Nick?
Shitty
now?
Bill.
Shitty Bill.
Shitty Nick.
Ooh. Come here.
Hey. Oh, God.
Oh. Wow. Oh.
Oh, you stupid cleric!
Is he healing him?
Yeah.
Oh. But he got me on his...
Oh!
Killed you?
Yeah.
Alright. Okay, let's both not suck. This is the Crestfallen episode.
Okay. Where are you?
I am a crestfallen knight.
I'm simply crestfallen. Oh, there you are. There was a dude who was doing, the Russian guy, whatever. He was clapping.
Yes, the clap.
Where is it? I don't have a clap emote.
I think you have to find it from someone.
I just wanted to test to see if you could really just clap and walk like he did. These knights are my bane. They're Jesse Bane.
They're okay, wait, hang on.
They're Jess Banes. What? What? You! Oh,
that's where this guy's coming from.
Oh, jeez. Lothric Knight Greatsword. Hey, what's this?
Lothric Knight Greatsword.
Lothric. Let's see. Lothric Knight.
Yeah, you gonna help me fight this guy?
Wait, I'm examining Lothric Knight Greatsword.
Okay, you can fight him then.
Oh, jeez. It's like I just ran in and put one heavy sword down on him.
Maybe now we can fight the boss.
Wait, what? What?
Oh, no, wait. You want to go kill the mimic? Revenge?
Yes.
Okay. Kill the mimic then.
Oh, God. Okay, so drop down here.
Don't die.
Wait, no. I wanted to study the
oh,
the chain. Sunlight straight sword.
There you go. Okay, now we can go through everything again.
Divine Tome of Lothric. What? What this?
The Divine Tome of Lothric. You can give it to your blind priest.
Oh, cool. Maybe I'll do that. Look at that sword. Where's this? What?
I dropped down.
No. I'm looking for the sword. Where is it? Where is it? Where? There. Nice. Okay. Okay, where are you?
I dropped down already.
Oh, yeah, you dropped down.
I need to go find the boss.
Okay. Sorry. Okay. Okay. So, so here we are. Where can I farm Titanite chunks?
That is a very good question. I actually don't know.
Huh, okay.
I know you can actually eventually get the vendor to start selling them.
Oh, nice. Okay, what is... What the heck? Oh, it's one of those things I was looking at. Oh, dude. What is... Dragon Slayer! Ah!
Ah! Wow, he one-shot you. Okay, hang on. Can we cut?
We will cut. Hold on, guys.
Moments later.
All right, we're back.
Yes.
We took care of business.
Taking care of business. But no. So there's actually an interesting way to fight that I just remembered for PvPing.
Okay.
So like here, let me show you really quick.
All right.
So normally when you're fighting somebody, you lock onto them and you just, you R1, you bumper swing at them.
Mm-hmm.
But if you don't lock onto them and you swing your camera and you move your character as you're swinging, you have like, you get a wider arc.
Oh, yeah.
You from being parried.
And what?
And it will prevent you from being parried. If like you rotate your character while you're swinging.
Oh, I see.
It actually prevents you from being parried.
Gotcha. Okay.
It's an interesting little tidbit.
Tidbit?
Yes.
Oh, this guy is... He... This is... The corpse.
Yes. Oh, yes. So how did you like the boss?
I didn't get to know him that well.
I mean, he certainly left an impression. Oh, no! This is where I would be clapping.
Hey!
I got this guy.
Okay. Whoa! Jeez! His swings are so mighty!
I saw that.
What happened?
You can kill him. Oh, just like on my screen, it looked like you, he hit you, and it didn't do any damage.
What did I do? Oh!
You died, didn't you?
Yeah! Dude, these guys are...
Bye.
So much head shaking. So much of the head is shaking.
Okay. Let me get my real sword on.
Someday we'll make it to the boss. Yes. Oh god, this message here says give it up. Is it my time sense. To go hollow?
Nope.
No? No hollowing?
Nope. We're not allowed.
Okay, hollowing is not allowed. I'm charging ahead. Charging ahead. We'll
I would not recommend that.
Cleric. Okay. 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 Down. Okay. 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 Large titanite shard. Okay. Not what I needed. I need titanite chunks, but okay. 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 Nice. 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 Okay. We made it to the boss?
Yep.
That's not merely that many guys to the boss, and yet it's enough to stop me.
We could just run and I'll fight them.
Oh, we could fight them. And we could fight them and not run. Okay.
All right, don't die this time.
Okay. Oh, wow. Whoa. Whoa, that is quite a weapon he's got. Whoa!
No, don't do that. I am in buffing hell.
No! 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 Yikes! Whoa! Oh, jeez. I will show you mighty swings. Whoa!
Win.
Damn, dude.
Wow, we beat that at record-breaking tries.
One actual serious attempt.
Yep.
Oof. You're gone.
I jumped.
Oh.
Just keep walking, you'll get to another bonfire, and then okay. We can go fight it.
We can go to the bonfire, we can go fight it! Fine work. Well then.
And you will see the most silly aspect of this game, in my opinion.
What?
Yeah, just keep going. You'll find a bonfire.
And then I'll see the most silly aspect in this game?
So you get the bonfire at the boss, and yeah. Then you're gonna walk up some steps and you're gonna find another bonfire. Where I'll be at.
Look carefully. What? Look carefully. Look carefully. What am I looking for? This message says to look carefully. What am I looking for? Look carefully. Look carefully.
There's only so much carefully you could look.
dead end ahead. What? What? There's a message up here. Bonfire? Bonfire. Yay! I made it to the bonfire! Okay, guys!